Radio 10, it is great to have your company. A fantastic studio audience with us today. Yeah. A big show coming up, including Joe Frost, former super nanny. Plus, we have a fabulous panel, including Vince Reddy stepping as guest host.
Yes.
Big Joe as well.
Yeah, I'm still here. Yeah. And Sarah Harris is back.
Yay! All right, lots of hot topics as always, so let's get into it. And first up, outspoken broadcaster Darren Hinch has slammed celebrities who are part of a push for mercy for two Aussies who were on death row in Bali. With Marianne Sukumaran and Andrew Chan now facing the firing squad, actors and public figures including Asha Keddie, Richard Roxburgh and Alan Jones have filmed themselves saying the words, "I stand for mercy" in support of the campaign asking for clemency. But Hinch calls them hypocrites, slamming the video on his own YouTube channel. Take a look.
They've all lined up, they've all signed up, and I think it's hypocritical. Now, I'm not that strong about drug dealers. I think Chappelle Corby should have probably got 6 months, the Bali Nine, maybe 6 years apiece. But that would have been in Australia. In Indonesia, they know when they commit crimes like this, then you could get the death penalty. It's the same in China, in Malaysia, in Thailand, in Vietnam. That's the risk you run. Data means death. I say hypocritical because are these people who are up there saying, you know, "I stand for mercy," is that just for Australian drug dealers or Australians on death row? Or is it for everybody? So if you're going to say, "I stand for mercy for everybody." If you're against the death penalty, be against it for everybody. You can't be a little bit pregnant.
Wow. Joe Casamento, let's start with you. Interestingly, Indonesia has also asked for clemency when its citizens overseas have been caught up on death row. I mean, what do you think of Hinch's comments?
Look, I think the use of the word hypocritical is unfair because I think these actors, and I know some of them, would say the death penalty per se they would stand up against. And I think because it's close to home, that's obviously why. And this particular campaign was started by Ben Quilty, who knows these actors and actresses. And that's why we're talking about it now. I think if the point of a judicial system is to reform those who are penalised, if, I mean, that's the basic principle of a prison system. And these two men actually are more reformed than many. And I've spoken with another prisoner who was in there, Paul Connaby, who wrote a book. And Andrew Chang has done some amazing things in the prison system. And I think that's why people are so, you know, these men have appeared to be reformed. And if that's what we're supposed to be doing, then,
Indonesian president, President Widodo, has said that there will be no clemency. And he pointed out, I mean, the drug figures are quite high for Indonesia. 50 people a day die from drugs in Indonesia. 18,000 people die every year, he said, from narcotics. That's why they're taking such a firm stand, because he says they have such a big problem. But, you know, I think your point is right, Joe. I think the two men have been rehabilitated and it would
but
be...
But it is their laws, isn't it?
Yeah, it is their laws. That's right. We all know that when we go there.
It makes you feel...
Yes, it's difficult to accept.
That's right. I mean, I think you have to be very clear. I mean, certainly the death penalty and certainly the way Indonesia meets it out, certainly for non-capital crimes, you would have to say the death penalty is a ridiculous overreaction and particularly in the way they do it by firing squad is absolutely barbaric, and I won't go through, but they actually inform, the prisoners are told with 72 hours notice that they will be executed, so they only have... They have 3 days to know they're going to die and no more and no less. They get told that there will be a target placed across their heart, that they're actually wearing. They can sit, lie or stand. They're given an option. They then, if all the shooters miss, they are then told that they
Isn't
will
the
get
point, though, that there are a lot of there are a lot of laws in other countries that we don't agree with, that we as well. I mean, you know, for example, you know, in some Middle Eastern countries, adultery is considered a capital punishment offence. offence, you know, and we don't stand up for that and say, well, you know, you shouldn't commit adultery in that country. Or female circumcision, you know, is okay. But we rail against that as well.
Well,
that's right, and that's why we're standing up against, you know, executions.
The point of this is who doesn't stand for mercy. I mean, I think Darren really is just looking for a bit of...
Well, you know what he said? In that same video, he said if there was a referendum today, 75% of Australians would support the death penalty. And I think... I don't know if that is correct.
Well, there is certainly support for it in the community. It's only because both the major parties refuse to embrace that argument that gratefully, we don't have it in Australia. But certainly, you know, yes, the death penalty is wrong, but to pretend that these people who are, I think, planning on importing, I think it was 8 kilograms of heroin to Australia, who weren't just drug mules, but these were the actual masterminds of it and were prepared to let others swing as well if they got caught with the drugs they were planning to export. These people, rehabilitated as they may be, these were people who are prepared to cause a huge amount of harm. So just because they're victims doesn't mean they're heroes.